So let's start with the next task on our agenda. And the last task was the pipeline module, where we gave you a short introduction into the pipeline module by integrating CI servers like Jenkins and executing it to build the application code and cover the backlog items and executing the automated test cases. Now we will look into more the reporting capabilities of ALM Octane, also provide you an overview for the end user by looking into the MyWork module and what capabilities you may have when you look into the workspace customization. So ALM Octane offers different reporting capabilities out of the box. We provide more than 30 plus widgets addressing different topics of your application lifecycle management. You can create run status graph by application modules or quality by your different key topics, defect cumulative flows, burn up, burn down charts, feature coverage analysis. So all this is provided out of the box and you can just use it by simple clicks. If there is a widget which is not provided and you want to create your own custom widgets, it's also possible. All the entities we have in ALM Octane, you are free to embrace and use and create your own filters and categorize these attributes on your specific need. We will look into it in a few minutes when we go into the demo. The MyWork module is the most important module for the different teams individuals, as they can see there centralized all the different topics which are assigned to them. So all the items which they are working on or they have been assigned to, like test cases or defects, or they have been mentioning in different comments of sections, or there were updates on the items and artifacts they were following in ALM Octane. All this information, they will never be missed out by the different users, so they will be notified accordingly. The workflow or the workspace customization we offer is here more on a wizard-like, so you don't need to script anymore like in ALM QC. You can design the workflow based on a visual wizard we provide and do the different transition definition. You can assign the groups and so on. You can create your forms and add additional fields. So all these topics you can easily cover with ALM Octane. So let's go into a quick live demo where I will give you a short introduction to my work module, customization, dashboard module, and reporting. So let's continue here with the dashboard module. So this is basically my dashboard module where I am currently working in. So all these widgets, they are provided out of the box. You can filter them directly. You don't need to copy the graph and change the filter and save it under a new name. You just can activate or deactivate different attributes to see exactly the information you are looking for. So if I want to see all the features which are in progress, I can just highlight the progress attribute and disable all the others. This is how easily you can report in ALM Octane. You can have here also different kind of release burn up, burn down charts, as I have started the release and sprint today. So this is not being displayed yet, but you can add here also different widgets. So up to 36 widgets we provide out of the box for different purposes like tracking progress. You have quality, content planning, test coverage, but also DevOps and analytics, where you really drill down into the more dev ecosystem specific reporting by hotspotting the code features, code in your repositories, risky comments, impact of any kind of changes. All these widgets you could use here directly from ALM Octane. If none of these widgets match to your requirement, you can add a custom graph. Just provide here a name. Let's see, this is sample. decide if it's a summary or current status graph or a trend status over time graph. You can define here the scope by selecting the different attributes we provide in ALM Octane, cover them by features or cover them by release. You can select the default release, so based on the date, the today's release will be used, or you can select here other releases which were maybe in the past to create the reporting as needed. You can provide additional filters. You can decide how to display by categories and X and Y axis. You can group the different attributes. It's very easy, and here, once you have it, you can create here the graph, save it, and it will appear here in your dashboard module. On top of this, we provide also OData support. So if you want to integrate any kind of BI reporting solutions from your organization, you they should be able to support OData protocol. Once they do, you can easily integrate all the data of ALM Octane in your BI solution. Let's go into the second module, which is my work module. And here I can see basically all the different attributes I'm working on. So I can see here the quality stories where, which I have created. I have here some user stories, manual run, which are assigned to me. So I can directly say I want to execute the test directly from here. So it will pop up the manual runner, and then I'm free to execute the test here, say pass. Pass all the iteration, pass, done. So I don't need to jump into a complex structure we used to know from ALM QC in the test lab module. I can directly see what has been assigned to me. Once I'm done, I can say dismiss, and it will disappear from my bucket of my work. I can see here notifications if any kind of update was done on the items I was following, and also the comment section, which I get notified if I'm mentioned in any artifacts comment, so it will be listed here, and I will not miss any kind of information. So the last section is the customization of the workspace. Let's quickly jump into it. So here you can see the customization area for ALM Octane for this workspace. I can see the different artifacts, and based on the artifacts, I can define different workflows based on different transition areas. You can have a different workflow for defects compared to user stories, or for quality stories, you have a different workflow. Same goes for the different test types you have. You can create here for test suites as well, for test suites and automated tests, as they are not really interactive items, there is no workflow, but for tasks you can have a different workflow here, where you say, okay, what are the different phases and transitions, and you define it directly in ALM Octane. You can also define the forms for creating and editing the different artifacts, and organize the fields as you like based on a visual designer, which helps you to quickly identify and create a task in this case, for example. And you have different other options where you can organize teams, users, put some DevOps specific integrations in, create your customized list, etc. But this is an overview section, so I don't want to go into a deep feature presentation. Let's return, and that was it basically from my side. So we have talked about the ALM introduction as a first video. Then we talked about the quality module as the heartbeat, where you can organize different test cases, use modern testing approaches such as BDD, manage your expert users and contributors, define your scopes and key topics. Then we jumped into the backlog and team backlog module, where I showed you Jira integration by synchronizing a simple user story, then consuming or adopting quality stories, which is a very new and nice type for agile project management, for providing visibility on the team internal task, which cannot be measured by the basic backlog functionality. We looked into the pipelines module, how you can integrate your CI servers and execute test cases to see the test results, basically in ALM Octane, failure analysis and insights, automated root cause analysis. And last but not least, we talked about some user-specific features like dashboarding, my work module, and workflow customization. Hope these sessions were useful to you. Thanks a lot. And if you have any additional questions, feel free to contact your Micro Focus representative in your country or contact me directly under amir.khan@microfocus.com. Thanks a lot.